I will ask to continue or to stop, because this is also very easy, same thing, but little bit extra, because you are dealing with 16-bit address. Our processor can take address of 1 byte at a time, so you need to do two things at a time. So small logic is available. You can understand it very easily. I will explain this part, and then we will continue or we will stop. It's up to you. Okay. Say, read the question here. Write a program to add contents of locations 2000 and 2001 H, okay, and store sum and carry in 2002 and 2003, respectively. The question is similar to your previous program. Okay, add contents of 20 and 21 H, store the result in 22 H and 23 H. It is quite similar, but the thing is that you are dealing with 16-bit address, so you can't go with R0 or R1 sum registers. Definitely you need to have, you need to use DPTR to hold this 16-bit address. Okay, I will explain here first and then I will explain here. So what is the idea, sir? Okay, don't see that part, don't see this part. Simply think what you need to do. If you want to add two contents available in one location 2000 and another is available in location 2001, and then you need to add, what you need to do, you need to take contents from that location into accumulator, and you can take in some other register and you can add, but that facility is not available here. Why? You see here, you see this diagram, you can understand everything. So microcontroller is available on a chip, okay, external RAM, so it is out of our microcontroller. So the only communication channel available between external RAM and our microcontroller is accumulator. Everything should be done through this accumulator. If you want to take the content from external RAM, you can see black arrows, okay, in left hand direction. That will be possible through accumulator. If I want to transfer content into external RAM, you can see right arrows with red ink. They are also passing through A. That means everything should be done with accumulator itself. So because of that thing, some instructions will added up. That is the only thing. So see here. First, in the previous example also, I have assumed what my carry is what. 0. So first instruction is what? 00. Okay. I have assumed this thing. First instruction, assume this thing. Second thing, what you will need to do? You need to initialize DPTR. So I will initialize DPTR with 2000 location. And now I will take the contents from this location into accumulator. Okay. And I will store this into some register R3. Because I need to take second content, that also have to be taken into accumulator. So for that reason, you concentrate on 3. What I am doing here, I am taking content into accumulator, I am storing that into R3, okay. Now I need to point to next location, so I will increment this DPTR, so I am pointing to this location. Now I will take the contents into accumulator, so this is available in accumulator. I can perform arithmetic operation, in that one operand is accumulator. Now I will do what? A plus this R3, addition operation, okay, using 7th instruction, then the result is available. Okay, but I need to store in location. So before transferring it, I need to increment this DPTR. So 8th number will be what? 8th instruction will be, it will be incrementing our DPTR. So you are pointing to this location. Now what you will do? You will move the contents from A into this location. Okay. Now what you need to do? Once again, you need to transfer the contents of R2. So for that, what you will do, sir? You will increment this location, and then what you will do? You can't directly transfer contents of R2 into this memory location. So here I have indicated with the cross mark that this operation will not be possible. So for that, what you need to do, you take R2 into A using 11th instruction from A to this carry location using 12th instruction. So this is very clear. Okay. If you understood this also, it is clear. Okay. You are using the instructions by writing comments here. Parallelly, you can understand. Okay, I will explain this thing. Our program starts. So before entering into program, what you will assume, sir? My carry is sum 00. Okay, it is initializing the carry or initializing this R2 register with 00. Now I need to point out to this memory location. Okay, so what I will do? I will initialize DPTR with what location? 2000. So move DPTR comma hash 2000. This will be taken as data into DPTR. Now you need to concentrate here, sir. You are taking data from external RAM into microcontroller. So what should be your instruction? Move X. It should not be move. It should be what? Move X. you are taking from external RAM. So move x a comma at the rate dptr, the content available in memory location pointed out by dptr is taken into a. So it is shown by instruction 3. Same thing is shown here, content available in external is taken into accumulator. Okay, now fourth is what you are transferring a into r3. See here, fourth move r3 comma a. Okay, now what you need to do, sir, after this thing you need to increment, you have transferred here, now you need to increment the location. Okay, so what I will write simply, instruction 5 is what, increment dptr, you have incremented, that means you are pointing to what location, 2001. What you need to do, sir, now you need to take this content into accumulator using 6. Where is 6? What is 6? Move x a comma at the rate dptr. Why x, sir? You are taking from external memory, because of that it should be move x, it should not be move. Okay, now after getting the content, I need to what, perform addition, add content of a and content of r3. Addition is done, I have shown this with 7. Okay, now you will get the result in accumulator and r2 register. Now what you need to do, you need to transfer, but where, in 2002. So what I will do, I will increment this 2001 to 2002 using instruction jump if, sorry, here you need to wait. I will increment this and I will do the operation. But before this thing, okay, before transferring the data, you need to worry about R2. That is what you need to worry about, carry. If my carry has generated or carry has not generated. So for that, in the previous program, I have also used the same thing. Jump if no carry to skip. If no carry is generated, it will jump to skip. Okay, then what it will do, if carry has been generated, then what it will do, it will increment R2, same thing. Now what it will do, increment dptr pointing to 2002. Now move x, sorry, here okay, you need to mention move x, not move, move x at the rate dptr comma a. What will happen, sir? The result available in a is stored in the location what, 2002. What will happen then, next, increment dptr. Why you are incrementing? To store the result of carry into 2003. Then what you need to do, sir, move a comma r2, take into r2. Why? Because from external RAM, everything should go into accumulator first and then to microcontroller. So r2 content is loaded into a and then a is moved into dptr, here as jump here to end the program. I think this program is very clear. Once again, if you want, I will explain. So to initialize our carry, I'm assuming carry is 0, taking initializing dptr with 2000 location, move x a comma dptr, that means content available 2000 is loaded into a using x, because it is pointing to external memory. Okay, now the content is loaded into r3, incrementing dptr to take next content. Once again, move x to take 2001 content into a, add a comma r3, content is loaded into accumulator, result is loaded. Now you need to worry about carry. If carry is generated, increment. Otherwise, if not generated, jump if no carry to skip and continue. Now increment dptr. Why we are incrementing, sir? We need to store the result in 2002. So for that, I am incrementing move x at the rate dptr. What is happening? The result sum is stored in 2002. Okay. Then increment dptr. Why, sir? I want to store the carry in next location. So it should be incremented 2003. Now you can't directly load, because it has to be done with accumulator, because we are dealing with external RAM. So what I will do, sir, I will load R2 into A, then I will move A contents into, that is carry contents into dptr, that is what, 2003 location. I think it is very clear. Here jump, here is used, sjump here is used to end the program. Now if you have any doubts, you can message me. And one more thing, I think it is better to stop now, and we will continue in the next class, because if you go through this programs in your free time today, then you can understand tomorrow's class very, very easily. You will feel it is very easy, simple adding of the two contents available different locations, but that different locations are what, internal RAM, that can be identified by saying 8-bit address, or external RAM, 16-bit address. Internal and external, how to do that thing, I will explain. Okay, so if you have any doubts, you can ask. you can message me. See if you have any doubts, you can ask right now, okay? No one is having any doubt? Students, am I audible to you people? See, if you don't have any doubts, that is well and good, okay? If one second, one student has posted. Sir, once explain about relative address. Relative address, okay. So where you have come across this word, relative address? You have come across this word, relative address, in SJUMP. That means I am explaining, I have taken the example of our 112 class. I want a student to go to 105 class and get the marker. So how I will explain the address? So come out of our class 112 and move in right hand direction 5 classes, then you will come across 105, get into that. So that is what I am explaining, that address, okay, 105 address with respect to 112. That means our address, our class is 112 is base address, and relative positions, displacement. So that address 105 becomes relative address. So that is what relative address, okay. I think this is clear. If you want more clarity, I can go to that particular slide also. This student, Sarpika. So am I clear? See, if I am clear, if you have understood the example, it's okay, you can mention it is clear. Otherwise, I will explain once again. See, our class is 112. Okay, if I want a student to go 105 and get marker, so how I will explain him? See, our class is a reference. You come out of the class, okay? Come out of the class and go in right hand direction. After crossing 5 classes, you will enter into 105. So that is, I am explaining that 105 address with respect to 112. That is my address. Our class address is 112 is what, base address. And he is moving relatively, moving from our reference position relatively. So that becomes relative address. Okay? Okay. Okay. Second question. Okay, second question posed by another student, Raju. Sir, 12th step, move X. Okay, once I will see this thing. 12th step. Yes, definitely. Yes, it is definitely, it should be move X. Okay, so that is well and good. Okay, you have identified a mistake in this means you have followed me and you have understood. So I will be happy with this mistake. Okay, you please, students, you please make correction. It has move X, okay? Definitely it should be move X, because you are transferring your contents from accumulator, from processor through accumulator into external RAM. So definitely it should be move X, okay? Okay. Okay, thank you for correcting me, student named Raju. Okay, definitely I feel very happy because you have corrected me, means you are following the instructions and you have understood the concept. Okay, everyone please note that 12th step, that is marked with 12 reading, there you need to mention move X at the rate of DPTR comma A, okay? Next question. Sir, once explain last steps after JNC. After JNC, okay. Okay, no issue. I will move to that thing. See here, JNC. You have understood this thing up to this point. So move. Once again, I will explain the program. It will be better. Everyone will follow. So we are assuming that our carry is zero. So I am loading that content into R2 register, initializing carry in some register. Move DPTR comma 2000 means I'm initializing DPTR with 2000, okay? Now move X, concentrate here, move X means from external. So from this 2000 memory location, I'm getting the content into A. Next, what I'm doing, I'm storing that content into some other register, that is move R3 comma A. Now I'm incrementing because I need to get the content of next location. So 2001 incrementing dptr, it becomes 2001. I need to get the content. Once again, move x a comma at the rate dptr, that means content available in 2001 will be loaded into A. Then what is happening, see, add A comma R3. You can see this seventh string here, you are adding A plus this R3, so addition will be performed, result will be stored in accumulator. Okay, now I am holding this result, I need to transfer this result into 2002, but I am holding the result, I am worrying about my carry has been generated or not. Result means it will be of two things, it will have some, it will have carry. So for that reason I am holding this seventh instruction here and I am worrying about carry. So I am writing one jump if no carry to the label skip. In your process, in this addition, if carry has not generated, then what will happen, sir? Jump if no carry to skip. Carry has not generated, then I will jump to what? Skip location, skip label. Then I will continue. What? Increment DPTR, that means 2001 becomes 2002. Now what I will do, I will store the result. So move x at the rate dptr comma a, that means result will be stored in this location 2002. Okay, then what will happen, increment dptr. Okay, so why I'm incrementing means 2002 should become 2003 to hold carry. Now I can't transfer the content of R2 directly to our 2003 because it is external. So what I need to do, I need to move R2 contents into A, and now using this 12th instruction, make a small correction here, move X at the rate DPTR comma A, that means content available in A, that is carry, is loaded into 2003 location. Okay, one more thing. So here what will happen, sir, if no carry, carry has not generated in our 7th instruction, in our result, so it will skip. Consider carry has generated, what will happen, sir? Jump with no carry to skip, it won't jump to skip. It will go to next instruction, that is increment R2. Now R2 has become 1. Now what will happen at the end? 2003 location will be getting what? 1. That is the thing. I hope it is very clear. Okay, this student, is it clear? Last steps after JNC. Okay, simply you can, if you have any other doubts, any other students, you can ask. Even if it is a very small doubt, that is not a big deal. Okay, I am here to explain you people. So should I end the session? If you want me to end the session, please message end.